Research shows alcohol can affect the immune system, and some of our viewers have asked, can drinking impact your response to the COVID-19 vaccines?
Our ABC 10 News anchor Derek Stahl is going in depth to explain why it's a topic of debate among health experts.
There are no published studies on alcohol and the COVID-19 vaccines. The CDC and the FDA have no official guidance on whether you should avoid it. So in the absence of evidence, health experts around the world have offered different takes. One nonprofit in the UK suggests people avoid drinking 2 days before the shot and up to 2 weeks after to ensure maximum effectiveness.
It's generally good advice. Again, I can't say that there's a ton of evidence to tell me exactly how many days before and how many days after.
I think I would really need to see the science behind that recommendation. It seems on the surface to be pretty extreme.
One expert pointed out that the Pfizer and Moderna clinical trials didn't ask volunteers to change their alcohol use. Tens of thousands of people took part. Presumably, some of those people had alcohol, and the vaccines were still about 95% effective. But other research suggests reasons for caution, says Dr. Christian Ramers of Family Health Centers of San Diego.
We do know that alcohol can suppress the immune system in many ways. The immune system is a very complicated thing.
A 2015 study found that just one episode of binge drinking had short-term effects on the immune system. Four or five drinks in one sitting led to lower levels of a certain kind of white blood cell within hours.
And if they're getting knocked down by a whole bunch of binge drinking, then yes, it's not going to work as well. So I think it's theoretically plausible that alcohol could really impair ultimately your ability to respond to the vaccine or to any other infection for that matter.
Again, just a theory. Another study found long-term heavy drinkers produced fewer antibodies to the pneumococcus vaccine. But Dr. Mark Sawyer says there's a big difference between alcoholics and the occasional drinker.
I think it's plausible that a binge drink in particular could cause a temporary effect, but again, I don't think it's likely to be of a substantial nature.
And then there's the question of side effects. A few ABC 10 News viewers said they took shots after their last shot and had intense side effects.
No doubt these vaccines cause a whole array of short-term side effects. Some people get headaches, some people get lightheaded, some people hear ringing in their ears. Nausea, all things that could overlap with symptoms that they get from alcohol, especially too much alcohol.
Overlapping symptoms, maybe, but he says there's no evidence alcohol triggers some kind of vaccine reaction. So can you have a few drinks before or after the vaccine? UCSF's Dr. Peter Chin-Hong.
I guess the taking point is, whenever you get this golden vaccine, sort of kind of like, you know, stay still, wait for your immune system to work, and don't perturbate that immune system too much.
He says if you do drink, do it in moderation. Derek Stahl, ABC 10 News.
Good advice, as always. And we want to thank our viewers for sending in that question. If you have a story that requires an in-depth look, ABC 10 News is listening. Send your ideas to tips@10news.com.